Hi, I'm Lindsay Chisholm, and I'm here at the Western Heritage Museum in the Lee County Cowboy Hall of Fame on the campus of New Mexico Junior College. I'm here to tell you all about the newest exhibit that will be on display from now until May 1st. It's called Bigger Than T-Rex. Did you know that T-Rex was not the most fearsome of dinosaurs? In 1991, a 45-foot-long dinosaur with a huge skull and big, sharp teeth was discovered in Patagonia, Argentina. Giganotosaurus, as it was called, was 14 foot tall and weighed 10 tons. That's taller and larger than the biggest T-Rex. And for the first time, you can view this giant dinosaur right here in the Southwest, as well as more. How about Mapasaurus, the most feared dinosaur of its time? Or Argentinosaurus, the largest animal to ever walk the earth? How about Allosaurus, the largest carnivore in the Jurassic period? And there's more. There's the fossil dig pit, where kids can actually dig up dinosaur bones. Or the fossil viewing area. How about the Children's Activity Center? Or the fossil dinosaur eggs? Finally, there's animatronics on loan to us from the Jurassic Park movie. How about let's go inside and meet some of the folks who are putting this great exhibit together? And we're here with Darrell Beauchamp, the director of the Western Heritage Museum and the Lee County Cowboy Hall of Fame. And you are introducing today to us this amazing new exhibit. Tell me a little bit about what the excitement is going on behind us.
This is bigger than T-Rex.
Literally.
Giganotosaurus.
I'm glad you can say that. I saw the other day you wrote it in phonetic spelling for me, and I appreciated it. The Giganotosaurus, he really is the emphasis of this exhibit because he is the new addition to the dinosaur world that now has been found to be bigger than what we thought was the largest with Tyrannosaurus Rex.
This is a special showing of dinosaurs that are mostly from Argentina, from South America, found by Don Lessem, who's the creator of Dino Don. And what they've done here is put together as the centerpiece of the show a dinosaur called Giganotosaurus. Giganotosaurus was bigger than T-Rex, and thus the name of the show. He was a large meat-eating dinosaur. We also have a Mapasaurus, which is a comparable size dinosaur to the Giganotosaurus. So two great big dinosaurs in this one exhibition. We also include some animatronic dinosaurs and some statics, a lot of bones, and a children's dig pit. For kids to play around and discover their own dinosaurs.
When you talk about the dig pit, I think that's always exciting because this really is the foundation of how we get these wonderful exhibits is people going out and digging for dinosaur bones. That's their mission in life, the archaeologists and what they're doing. Teaching these children the process is really key to letting them understand the full the kind of value of what we've got here.
Right, archaeologists and paleontologists, people who study dinosaurs, go out and they find these dinosaur bones and then they have to be uncovered an inch at a time, a little bit at a time. As we cumber these bones, then they're taken back and restored, and then we make casts of them for display in museums around the country.
And how lucky are we to get this? Because this is something that travels all over, and it's in much larger cities than Hobbs and in Lee County most of the time, correct?
We're very fortunate that in Lee County we've got the support of great foundations and great support of the college in order to bring in what we call a national show. And this is a national show. The closest it's been to us is in Phoenix recently. And so, you know, people are going to have a chance to see something here in Hobbs that they're only going to get to see in other major cities.
And with that, you are linking these opportunities for family to come out. Obviously, kids are going to love it. Adults are going to love it. But you're encouraging these family fun days so that we can come out and enjoy it together.
The final Saturday of every month of the show, so January, February, March, and April, on the last Saturday of that month, we're having a thing called Family Fun Day. And that's a free day for families to come out and learn together. We're going to have guest speakers. We'll have books for sale, toys for sale in the museum store, a movie every Sunday. And we're going to feature a different kind of speaker each time. We think it's going to be an exciting family fun day for each of those Saturdays.
Well, we are very excited to get to go through this exhibit through the next few months here at the Western Heritage Museum and the Lee County Cowboy Hall of Fame. And we thank you very much for helping to bring this to Lee County.
Well, we're open with this exhibit until May the 1st. We hope everybody will come out. A rare opportunity, but it's going to close on May 1st with no excuses. We hope everybody will come out and see it.
That's Darrell Beauchamp with the Western Heritage Museum and the Lee County Cowboy Hall of Fame with the Bigger Than T-Rex exhibit. I'd like to introduce you now to Ken Diggs, the exhibit technician for Bigger Than T-Rex. Welcome to Lee County, and how exciting is it to bring this type of exhibit to a smaller community maybe than you're used to?
It's great. I mean, just to see the people who work here have been coming by and seeing this big guy and just the looks on their faces when the jaw drops and all that.
You know that we are not used to maybe something quite so exciting. They bring in amazing exhibits of various kinds, but dinosaurs really appeal to the masses, children, adults. Everyone has a fascination because we've never really seen one in person other than what people like you bring to us. What is it that makes this so much fun for you that you could continue to travel across the country and provide it to everyone?
For me, I love meeting the museum people. I love seeing different facilities, and I went through all the Cowboy Hall of Fame stuff and was just amazed. And then those guys go shoulder to shoulder with me to set up the big guy.
A team effort.
Yes, exactly.
When you're building these from place to place, what is the most challenging piece of putting these together and making sure that you make the exhibit all it's supposed to be and designed to be for each different location?
Well, the biggest challenge is the assembly of the Giganotosaurus.
Okay.
Just here, as a matter of fact, we're having to be very careful. The carpet can be damaged by the forklift that's required to lift this giant rib cage up into place and put it down on top of its legs. And you won't believe how much bigger this thing looks when it's up.
When it's all finished.
Right. And we're having to take extra care just to make sure that, the carpet is not damaged and that everything is just as it should be.
Obviously, you don't want to damage the bones as well. You mentioned, is this one piece? How many of these are quite large, or how many of them separate out to smaller pieces? Is it really much more small pieces than we expect when we see it finished?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, it's just sort of a seamless, you just see this giant dinosaur standing here. I mean, at the moment, the parts are separated.
Right.
But we're going to get those, we're going to get it stood up and everything bolted into place, and then it looks like it could just walk up to you.
People have no idea how many different parts there are that you have to put together. How do you travel with these? Are they boxed up? Are they shipped in a truck? Do they have to be somehow handled very specially? I imagine that you have to take great care when you're moving from location to location.
Yes, as a matter of fact, big fossil casts like this are more suited to a permanent exhibit.
Okay.
So there are challenges to moving them around to different facilities. They have to be, every piece has to be bubble wrapped, and they do arrive on a big truck strapped down, and you have to unload them very carefully. And because of the fragility of these fossil casts, there's always some touch-up to be done on the other end. So the next couple of days, you'll come in here and you'll see me on a ladder with my little glue touching everything up.
Fine-tuning as we speak. I know that when you are going, that's one reason why they have you or an individual that has to take, because you obviously know how to set it up. If someone were not familiar with this process, I imagine it would take two or three times as long to know what pieces to put together, much like a puzzle.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, don't try this at home. You're not going to be able to set it up without knowing how everything goes together.
I want you to describe for me, we talked about there being real bones, and then obviously there's the animatronics, I believe, is what we've referred to them as. How are those pieces different than putting together these real bone structures?
Well, the animatronics give you an opportunity to see what some of these creatures would look like fleshed out. They're made with a very realistic silicone skin that has a nice lifelike jiggle to it. And every museum has to come up with a compressed air system to run these creatures, because they run on cylinders that move back and forth inside the creatures, running off compressed air controlled by a computer.
So when we go through the exhibit, they'll actually move. They have, I believe, noises and sounds that are also included in it. You'll really feel like what it potentially would be if you were to walk upon one of these dinosaurs back in the days of them living in our Earth.
Yes, we've got a Saurolophus, which is the big guy back here. We've got a Velociraptor, which everyone knows from Jurassic Park.
I knew that one right away, yeah.
And an Oviraptor, which that's going to strike people as looking really strange. They've got a bird-like head and a beak and spindly little fingers. And the guy's unloading it this morning thought, whoa, that is a very strange-looking creature.
It could be scary in a dark room. Good thing is that this room is going to be lit and in perfect format to highlight each of these individual shapes. What is your favorite piece out of the entire exhibit?
Oh, got to be the star of the show, the Giganotosaurus. He just, when he's up in place, he's just so imposing. I mean, bigger than T-Rex.
It's going to be incredible. We appreciate you coming and visiting Lee County to help set up this amazing exhibit. Bigger than T-Rex, Ken Diggs, the man behind the magic. We appreciate you being here, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is a great show, and you can come view Bigger Than T-Rex Tuesday through Sunday during our normal museum hours. And don't forget to join us the last Saturday of every month for Family Fun Days, where there's special activities for the kids and free admission for the whole family to get into the show. We hope you enjoy Bigger Than T-Rex from now until May 1st here at the Western Heritage Museum and the Lee County Cowboy Hall of Fame.